Spring forward, fall back. Whether you give it much thought or not, daylight saving time has actually been pretty controversial. So what's the reasoning behind it?
We move our clocks ahead 1 hour in March to inject more sunlight into the evenings. Simple enough. When we do this, we also lose an hour of sleep. This is what we call daylight saving time, and the rest of the year we label as standard time. The primary rationale for the time change, which took hold more than 100 years ago, was to conserve energy, which in turn saved money. But the concept has been around for a lot longer. Benjamin Franklin proposed a time change back in 1784, when he was ambassador to Paris. He suggested it would save the city 64 million pounds of candle wax. Over a century later, the idea was brought up in New Zealand by an entomologist who wanted more sunlight to collect bugs. His pitch was squashed. Then, uber-industrious Germany was the first country to implement it as a way to cut back on coal costs during World War I. It gained popularity from there. But what few people know is that daylight saving time was actually first established in a small town in Canada. The city, now known as Thunder Bay, Ontario, was the first place in the world to turn back the clock in 1908. Now, daylight saving time is used by more than a billion people in over 70 countries around the world. The farther away you go from the equator, the more likely daylight saving time is implemented. If you think about it, this usually means seasonal variations. So when the hotter days roll around, people are more likely to spend time outside and therefore use less artificial lighting, right? While this may have worked to save energy in society 100 years ago, does it still hold true in the modern world?
Surprisingly, that's a very difficult question to answer.
There is little evidence that daylight saving time actually saves energy. In fact, it's difficult to study because technology is evolving so fast. Think coal burning, the magnificent air conditioner, the switch from tungsten light bulbs to LEDs. And as technology keeps getting better and better, we're filled with a world of distractions. The bottom line, there are thousands of studies that provide contradictory findings. Some conclude that daylight saving time saves electricity, while others conclude it actually costs more. But one thing they agree on is the effect size of energy consumption. It's either 1% more expensive or 1% less expensive, which is the equivalent to either $13 saved or $13 spent a year for one US household. To make things more complicated, even within countries, daylight saving time isn't consistent. In Canada, it's adopted in all provinces except for Saskatchewan. And in the US, it's implemented everywhere except for Hawaii and Arizona. The application of daylight saving time is also not consistent around Europe, and many countries are pushing to abolish it.
So now the question becomes, is the hassle of twiddling the clocks twice a year really worth it?
From a purely health perspective, you're probably better off not having these shifts.
Dr. Andrew Lim, a neurologist who's focused a lot of his research on sleep disorders, says the change affects your sleep-wake cycle. And according to one US study, switching over to daylight saving time and losing 1 hour of sleep raised the risk of having a heart attack the following Monday by 25% compared to other Mondays during the year. Essentially, the shifts are disrupting your circadian clock. Here's what that means.
So the circadian clock is the body's internal biological clock. It's what allows the body to stay synchronized to the day-night cycle. And it actually controls a whole host of physiological functions in pretty much every organ in the body.
So it isn't so much your own biological clock that is shifting, but it's the world around you.
And what happens is the shift in the biological clock actually lags a little bit. It's almost like a form of jet lag.
Okay, so not worth it from a health perspective. But what effect would it have on the economy?
On average, when you're looking at the US, the single day loss from this effect amounts to about $30 billion on average. So it's economically consequential.
Lisa Kramer, a professor of finance at the University of Toronto, studied the effects changing the clocks had on the stock market in Canada, the US, the UK, and Germany. And what she found is that the following Monday, although there is typically a dip in the stock market, the negative returns are 2 to 5 times larger in magnitude following daylight saving time. While it's not obvious if daylight saving time has a clear purpose, we need to ask ourselves, are we holding on to the practice because of tradition? If this is the only reason, it might be time for a change.
Do you want me to wait for that to finish, or?
Okay. We're making good time.
Okay.
It's 3 right now.
And that's such a cool sound. It's like when you do yoga. Namaste. Ding.